Now, this is the programming sequence of NORMAD ES4. We are going to reprogram the system. The first thing to do, to concentrate only for S1, which is the switch cylinder control, S3 power limit potentiometer for reprogramming, and S4 for the dip switches reprogramming. Make sure that this is only the active parts or the switches that needs to be reprogrammed. I will repeat, S1, which is the switch cylinder control, S3, which is the power limit or potentiometer, S4 is the dip switches. As now, this is slide number 2. See, this is the actual site installation of ES4. You could see that the first picture on the left side is the picture that was taken or that was installed by our company, Mesper Aldosari company. Now, the second is the actual control switch position. See, this one is magnified. See? So on the right part, on the center of the console facing front, if you open or take off the cover, you will see there are certain dip switches or different switches. S1, okay, that is a rotary switch for the type of cylinder that was installed inside, or the type model that is installed under this ES4 humidifier, what type of cylinder this is. So we need to readjust it. Okay. Second is S2, which is the drain factor. So don't concentrate on S2 because that is already default factory setting. Third is S3. S3 is the power limit or the potentiometer. This is the one that controls the heating element. So you could see that if there is so much heat, which is consuming around 100%, there would be a possibility of too much moisture, see, or mist that will carry over to the distribution exhaust fans of the duct. That is the reason why there are mist or slight water that was because due to the moisture. So we need to readjust or reprogram it using the S3 switch. Okay, the next and the last is S4, which is the dip switch. This is the general switch configuration, see, that needs to be followed. So it's all clear that we have 4 switches that we need to reprogram: S1, S2, S4, and S3. On the third slide, I will show you on how to do the programming. Now, this is the basic reprogramming steps for ES4 configuration. First step is to turn off the ES4 main switch, which is located on front or on the side of the system. Then after this one, turn off the line, the main breaker switch, which connects the ES4. This one is the power that was the supplied power, the 400 volts AC. Once you turn off the power already, now we will proceed on step number 2. First, concentrate, let's go for the programming of the S1 for the cylinder switch. Now, on S1, there is what you call, I put a violet arrow facing this S1. you will see that this one needs to be pulled under position A for the model 4564A, because this is the model of our humidifier. So put the S1 switch to position A by using precision tools to adjust this one. Make sure that the precision tools, see, has an insulation so to prevent hazardous or hazard shocks that might occur. See, make sure that to, as per operation number one, under number one, turn off the power first. Now, after this one, if you put the cylinder switch or S1 to position A, then go to switch or the rotary switch S3, which is under color yellow. That's the arrow. Now, as a default setting, you could see that this is placed under, the arrow is placed under position 1, which goes for 100% power setting. Now, to decrease the heating element, because this S3 controls the heating element, what we will do, or this is what you call the power setting element or the potentiometer, what we will do is we are going to adjust it to 0.5, which is 50% of the power output. That is our first adjustment. It will be quite a trial and error method. So we go for 0.5 or 50%. You will see on the rotary switch for this one that there is 0.5. Select this one and put the arrow to 0.5. That is for S3. After S3, we are going to go to the third step, which is the S4 general setting dip switches. This dip switches has two selections. Okay, you have an off and on. Off is on the left side and on is on the right side. So I have already set all the configuration and you just need to follow this up. Okay, let's go for number one. Put that on the ops position, that is the normal water condition. Number two, put that to on position using a precision tool also as a draining activation for 72 hours. Number three, go for on position also, force draining activation for 72 hours. Number four, turn it to off for the activation of cylinder replacement for 1500 hours. Number five, put that on the on position for heating voltage deactivation if you are going to replace cylinders, which is item number four. And number six, that is the offset signal has to be deactivated because we are not using any connections outside. It is just on the system itself. There's no potentiometer meter outside connection or humidstat, which is connected outside. So just follow this dip switches position. Now, after doing step number three, we'll proceed to step number four. Turn on the system. Before turning it off, make sure that all water's connection or water inlet supply is you know, is owned. There should be a supply of water inlet. It is also quite necessary to drain the system. So how are we going to drain? Just press the drain button in front of the water drain button in front of the switch, which is indicated on this one. Press it for 3 seconds. So automatically there would be a force activation of draining the water. Once everything is okay, see, turn on the system and try to monitor it. How are we going to make sure that there is no more moist water coming out from the exhaust fans, from the duct fans? See, you will see this one after such time that the system already produced the proper moisture and the system turns to green. Make sure that every 6 hours or 5 hours, try to go to the fans if you see that they are, you know, releasing moist or some mist water. Now, if not, try to go to the same procedure again and put it the limit or the power switch or potentiometer into 30% or a minimum limit of number 2. That is under the rotating switch number 2, which is roughly around 30% under S3. So that's all. So just follow this instruction and you could adapt this one to the other 7 systems or 8 systems that was installed by our group. Thank you. So once all the system was made or the programming was made already, the last thing is just to monitor it. As I told you, you have to see if there are mist coming out from the distribution of the exhaust ducts. If there are so much mist, and then just try to adjust the potentiometer so to limit it to 30%. So this will be a trial and error basis. So might as well, it's better to allocate a guy or a technician on the side of PSMMC, or so that he will go there every 4 or 6 hours to see if there are so much or too much mist coming out of the duct exhaust system. So once this one is already regulated and it was already acceptable, that's the time to adapt it to the other systems or to the other remaining 7 systems. So that's it. Now I think that was cleared. That is has been discussed to you. And we make it assured that we are going to give you that Mesper Aldosari Contracting Company will give you a full support for every installation or every project that our engineering guys had accomplished for PSMMC or for Prince Sultan Military Hospital. That's all, and thank you. And for any further questions and details, you just try to email or contact us on the indicated numbers. Thank you. This is Engineer Frank Dimapilis reporting or conducting this video presentation for the reprogramming of ES4 humidifier system. That's all, and God bless.